I have 2010 Honda Odyssey, and today I'm going to install the SVCM controller on it. This 2010 Honda Odyssey comes with an engine that has a VCM functionality, or vehicle cylinder management functionality. What it does is, in order to gain fuel economy, it turns off some cylinders of the engine, but that puts load on the ones that keep on functioning, and that causes some issues in the vehicle, like cylinder misfire, and the engine will start consuming oil. So I'm going to install the SVCM controller. What that does, it bypasses the VCM functionality. Basically, all six cylinders will keep on functioning. I bought this SVCM controller online. It comes like this. Looks like just two connectors and the device itself and some zip ties. Very good detailed instructions on how to install it. And the main thing they say is not let it touch the engine components. So these zip ties that it comes with will help secure it to the wiring harness, which is right here. The tools I need to install the SVCM controller are a flathead screwdriver to remove the engine cover, a 10 millimeter socket, a ratchet, a 3-inch extension, and an adapter. This is to install the wire on the battery terminal, and then scissors to cut the extra off on the zip ties. To install the SVCM controller, I gotta remove the engine cover. Use flathead screwdriver to turn it 90 degrees. Lift the cover. The SVCM controller is going to install in between this wire or this connector and the engine. So for that, I'm gonna remove this connector, which is to press on the tab and then pull it up. Just press up here and lift it. I'm going to do that with my left hand. And like that, just disconnect this wire. Open the packet the SVCM came in. So just this. What this is, connect this connector, which is a male component, first. You heard the click sound, which is awesome. So the manufacturer says to connect the VCM controller to the wiring harness first before connecting it over to the sensor on the engine. If you do that, I mean, which I did in the first, this is not long enough to go all the way to the connector. So I'm gonna install the connector first, and then I'm gonna put the zip tie over the VCM controller. So this is what I've done, is put a zip tie around it so the SVCM controller would not touch the hot engine surface. And the zip tie is around all three wires. So everything is connected. Now I gotta do is connect this wire to the battery. I use a 10 millimeter to open. I'm gonna put this wire, take this wire, connect it here. And that should do it. And have that go from here. So I have two more zip ties. So I'm going to connect this loose wire over to the harness here. I'll cut this extra off. I put one zip tie over here for the wire that goes onto the battery terminal, a zip tie over here, and of course a zip tie here to hold the SVCM controller. So this time the SVCM controller is installed, and I'll put the engine cover back on. To install the engine cover, I'm gonna lock it in place. And we're good to go. Thanks for watching.